Hello and welcome in this tutorial. This time I'd like to show you a nice trick how you can make those gimmicky borders where an image looks like it would be behind here, but above here. If you want to know how to do such designs and how to create such slides, head on to the tutorial and let's go. Okay, hello, let me give you a great idea with this slide. So as usual, I'll delete everything. Now I'll import a picture that I've prepared. Okay, this is a simple picture we can use, for example, for this design. Let me close the design ideas. And if you are searching for such a color scheme, I was, for example, using a site called colors.co. But that doesn't matter. I just wanted a simple color scheme I could use for this slide. So let's say that you are planning on doing an image on the left side. At first, you would like to crop this image to be a rectangle. So I'll hit this image. I make it a bit smaller with my shift key. Okay. I place it on the left side, then I go to the right upper corner. Once I have format selected, I go to crop, crop to shape or aspect ratio, and I select a square 1:1 dimensions. Okay, now I am sure that what I have is a square. Okay, let me position the bird I have, like this. Okay, then again click crop. Okay, this is my first object. I'll make it a bit smaller. I know this is a perfect rectangle, and I'll rotate it a little bit just because I want to have some fun with this design. Let me go to Insert, Shapes, and select a simple, very simple rectangle shape. With my Shift key, I make a perfect rectangle to about the size of this image. Okay, ugly enough? It is. So now I'll work with the Shape Fill and Shape Outline. Shape Fill, no fill. Shape Outline, wait. And I want even more than 6 pixels. Let me select more lines, and in the width, I'll select like 10 points. Let me go by hand. 6, 7, 8. Okay, 9 should be enough. I don't want it to be too much. And the trick I would like to use is, how could I reveal just one corner and one corner to stay like that? So at first, let me change the color of this object. I'll go once again to Format, Shape Outline, Eyedropper. I click and I select one of the blue colors I've prepared. Okay, I have a really nice blue. Now, I'll right click and send this to back. Now, I have my effect. This is hidden and this is hidden, but how could I reveal this one? Can I make it like 3D, or can I crop the image so it will be hidden here? Well, not exactly, but we can use some simple PowerPoint tricks. What I would do instantly, I'd go to Insert, Shapes. I would select another shape, for example, like this one. It's called half frame, and I would make a frame like that, to half of the size. Then I would come closer with my left control and the scroll wheel. Okay, let me go to the right place. PowerPoint is making this really easy for me, and I'll try to adjust it to the perfect position. Also select shape outline, no outline, because this time we'll work with the fill. Shape fill, let's maybe make it orange so I see better the color cover. Okay, now it's covered. Now the last adjustments are, I need to come closer. The last adjustments, thank you PowerPoint, you are making this really easy. The last adjustments would be making those lines equal to this position. Now equal to this position, and this is why I used an orange color, because I can see now the differences perfectly. Okay, I have this object prepared. And no one sees that, only you. I would take this object, I would select shape fill, and I would select the recent color. Boom, and look at the effect. Isn't it beautiful? This image looks as I would shift it behind this frame, but here it is still revealed. What you can do, you can also select the bigger frame, the frame we did here. You can right click and format shape like I have opened here. And I could, for example, select a solid fill. Not for the line should stay blue as it was. I should make this for fill. So I'll close the line and select this color. Eyedropper, this color, not so strong, transparency. Okay, and this is a beautiful effect we can achieve. And I would now select the left item. I would copy it. I would, of course, rotate it. I would make it with my shift key smaller. And this could be like the beginning of a great template or another cool slide. So I would now need to adjust those items to make them more viable, because right now they do not look okay. So I would create something like this, and I would assume that this is my template. Now I would go to insert, text box, and I would start to populate this slide with text. Give me a few seconds to do that. Just imagine how good will this look if you use some interesting text, like I for example used here Nexabold font, Nexabold and Nexalite, and if you distribute everything properly, like you use a text for a headline, for a title, for the main content, the entire slide will look really decent. Let me now delete the color scheme because I don't need it anymore, and this is how I would see the end result.